We have assurances tonight that the Cayman Islands and overseas territories have nothing to fear from the leadership challenges in the UK. This as the race for a new Prime Minister heats up. UK Minister of State and the Foreign and Commonwealth Office, Lord Tariq Ahmad, addressed the issue today. And as Cayman 27's Andrew Harris reports, Lord Ahmad believes there is a place for all the OTs in a post-Brexit Britain.
The implications of the House's decision are grave.
As political turmoil continues to brew in the UK Parliament, Overseas Territories Minister Lord Ahmad of Wimbledon brings words of comfort to all OTs.
Well, the first assurance I can give you, I know both individuals who will be the next Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Former Foreign Secretary Mr Johnson, current Foreign Secretary Mr Hunt.
Lord Ahmad says regardless of who takes the reins, Britain is entering a new chapter and there will be hurdles along the way.
There will be challenges, and I'm being very upfront with you, within a parliamentary democracy when certain issues come to the fore.
But he says overseas territory rights to govern their own domestic affairs when it comes to issues such as LGBT legislation will be respected.
And we have to ensure that working in partnership with the overseas territories, we present a robust case to our parliamentary colleagues to ensure that the essence of the ability to the OTs working forward themselves on these important issues is not just sustained but strengthened.
Speaking at the inaugural UK OT International Trade Summit Thursday morning, Lord Ahmad recited a poem calling on all OTs to remain steadfast no matter the challenges.
Walk on, walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and from me to you, you'll never walk alone.
Andrew Harris, Cayman 27.